Parents, staying hostel. There is an army officer, I have served in Sikkim, most in hospital, but the rain of Sikkim, that is not Sikkim. There are 3 areas in Iraq, 1 area in Northeast. I have been a deputy president of the selection board, located in Allahabad, which caters for the northern and northeastern states of our country for selection of officers for the Indian Army, Navy, and Air Force. With this kind of experience, I would like to share with you as to what we as Ladakhis or students from the northeast of the hilly areas, what kind of problem we face, and certain advisories based on my experience my exposure as an SSR to interview candidates from this area. First of all, in our area, we do not have the infrastructure for education. That's why we come away from our parents to places like Calcutta, Bangalore, Delhi, Chandigarh. First mistake, what we do is that we remain in our own circle. We do not mix up with the people who are here. Otherwise, mixing with them will give us a lot of knowledge, a lot of experience. If knowledge is shared, then only it will increase. We tend to remain in isolated groups. One of the solutions is that we should get involved. Like I have interviewed a lot of candidates from the hilly areas. Any candidate who has participated in group activities, like group games, like volleyball, football, kabaddi, other than the single individual games, They always have an upper hand during interview or from any during any selection process. And also, like NCC is one of the facilities in almost all the colleges, you must participate. It inculcates or it develops group oriented activities. It encourages you to be a group minded person. These days, even in the corporate sector also, they prefer to have a group-minded person rather than an individual person. In government services also, they always, during the interview, you would have seen that HR round is given the maximum weightage. That HR round involves that you are group-minded and you are not single or selfish-minded person. Second is that we do not have continuous or periodical counseling. It is not that if a child is doing badly, he should be counseled. It is not like that. If a child is doing good, he has to be counseled. For example, if a person does not study much and he is scoring good marks, he needs to be counseled. Otherwise, he will become a happy-go-lucky type, a overconfident person. It is said in psychology or in the SSR's faculty that overconfidence is more dangerous than underconfidence. Underconfidence is trainable, but any person who is overconfident is not trainable. He cannot be trained. So counseling is must. A person, a child being studying a lot and scoring good marks also needs to be counseled. Similarly, a person who studies a lot and does not get good marks, if he is not counseled by an expert person or an experienced person, he will lose his confidence and he will lose hope in his life. So he has to be counseled, and we do not have that facility. And our parents or our elders do not have that tradition of counseling a child theoretically. Third is that we react to the situation. That is, we wait for the examination result, that is, 10th board exam, 12th board exam, or final board exam, or final exams. Then based on the percentage, we decide our future course of action, which is not correct. Like if you have passed your 10th class, based on the attitude of the child, based on the attitude of the candidate, we should decide his course of action. Accordingly, take coaching, do preparation. Like if you want to appear for competitive exams after graduation, it should happen that once you have got the degree, you start planning. No. It is in the second or the third year. Minimum 2 years, you must have reaction time for yourself to do coaching, do some group studies, select your study group like that. Like After having seen a lot of people from the difficult areas like North East, Sikkim, Himachal Pradesh, Ladakh, my experience is that Army is one of the, if not the best, one of the best profession career for us. You should consider it as a career option. You should not close the chapter. Army, as today, pays you well. Every year in your career profile, it gives you sufficient opportunity to develop your personality, progress academically, technically, or professionally. It gives you all the opportunity. Once you join Army, every day you are learning. It is not that you are in a profession and you are learning only Army professionals. No. Army gives you opportunity to do M.Tech from IITs, AIMS, MBA from AIMS, free of cost. And you get all the benefits, all the facilities when you are doing that. And based on the personality profile of the people from the Hilly region, if you see their career, that is their life style, Army is just for that. The type of lifestyle given to Army officers of the Army personnel, it suits us. So if you know what I see, most of the people, they close the option of Army. It is very good, it is very good career option for all of us. With this, with so much of always we are gathering, it will not be correct on my part to take too much of your time. I thank the president of various associations to give me this opportunity to express my experience as a student, as an officer, and as an SI. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.